In a House GOP conference meeting on Tuesday, House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy led into an effort by some in the party to lead a discharge petition to force an amnesty bill to the floor of the House of Representatives. "Our numbers are better," McCarthy told House GOP members, per a source in the room. "If election is today, we win. Will we continue to grow? But few things can disrupt us. We cannot disrupt ourselves." An additional source in the room told Breitbart News that McCarthy made clear this was the surest way to the minority for House Republicans. "McCarthy laid down the marker that this is the surest way to the minority," a source familiar with McCarthy's remarks said. The message was loud and clear. Breitbart News' Neil Monroe explained the discharge petition effort this way. "If the 17 GOP members can collect a total of 25 GOP signatures on their discharge petition, then 193 Democrats will join them to get the 218 signatures needed to stage a floor vote, despite leadership opposition. Their planned floor vote will be a rare Queen of the Hill debate around four bills. That plan will allow Business First GOP legislators to unite behind an amnesty bill that will pass with support from 193 Democrats, and also split their votes to ensure the failure of pro-American immigration bills." McCarthy will highlight how it is National Police Week and remember and honor immigration officers at the White House. "These officers are sentinels for our Constitution, our borders, and for the rule of law itself," McCarthy will say. He will also discuss how Republicans, under Trump's leadership, have stepped up on immigration enforcement. McCarthy will also hammer Democrat obstruction. And McCarthy will also say that enforcement and obeying of immigration is essential, not optional. "Federal law is the supreme law of the land, and immigration laws are no different," McCarthy will say. "Obeying these laws is not optional, it is essential to the good working order of our government. Federal immigration officers deserve our respect for the dangerous and difficult work they do. More than that, they deserve our full support. This administration and this House have their backs. I know the American people do, too."